later.
Okay. Really good.
So, does being a keeper use your brain?
No. At that point of time when we started the YouTube channel, I didn't even know of the term YouTuber. I didn't know there were people who call themselves YouTubers. When I was in a band during that time, we were asked to open for Wong Fu Productions. They were coming to KL. And I asked the organizer, who is Wong Fu Productions? Are they the Chinese band? So it was quite funny. Then, these guys are YouTubers. There's such thing because they do videos on YouTube, so we call it. Yeah, so at the start, it was just about making films, making short films, coming up with ideas to just put it on screen, and there was no plan on, oh, I wanna get subscribers, I wanna get the silver play button or so on and so forth. There was nothing like that. Yeah.
Are you used to being called a celebrity?
No celebrity,
after all these years,
no influencer, no YouTuber, no. Yeah, all. I feel like all these terms, it's something that I'll never get used to being called. The most I'm used to being called is, you make film, you're a filmmaker. I'm cool with that. Yes, because that's my occupation. I'm trying to find that group of people who likes what I like. And hopefully one day this group grows, so at least set to say the business world, they see numbers, so hopefully through that I can make more.
Any challenges that you face along the way?
A lot.
Maybe some.
Yeah, a lot of challenges. The biggest challenge is to actually run production house, which is a business, and also run a YouTube channel. When it comes to client managing and you have no experience, it's easy for creative people to feel angry about changes, especially. But changes happen a lot in this industry. It's when being a creative, right? When people shoot down your idea, that's the worst feeling. You feel angry, you feel like, don't know what you're talking about. I know, yeah. But the first 2 years was like that. The ego was too big, the creative ego was too big, and I had to take a step back. I had to learn from burning up bridges. So I guess learning that through mistakes was the biggest challenge. Back then, when we started, there was no such thing as YouTubers. That's 2011. So there was no guide from YouTube. If you become a YouTuber now, there's so many examples online to learn mistakes from. There's us, the first generation of Malaysian YouTubers, whom you see fail in some ways. And so if I knew back then, you shouldn't upload rojak content on your channel, because consistency is key with YouTube channels. So if I started with short films and went all the way, then maybe my subscriber would be a million by now. I have friends and family, including my wife and even my teammates nowadays. I think they're all big motivators. If you follow my video, I was recently diagnosed with cancer and stuff. So yeah, I have cancer. Yeah, I have to go through these few other things, but do I forsake work? Do I stop doing what I'm supposed to do? I still have to turn on the mode and come back and continue the chase. Yeah, I'm thankful for a lot of things in this world. Like, for people who thought things they have cancer, I hope they catch it early thanks to the video. And those who are fighting it, I hope it encouraged them. And I can feel that people who had it are starting to open more, because a lot of them say it was very shy to talk about it. It was a big no-no to say cancer. Even the word cancer is like a no-no, not good, no, not good enough.
So how do you plan to use your power as a YouTuber to, you know, keep on spreading the awareness?
So the plan now is to just document the journey. Even though it's going to be painful for me, there will be times, maybe going through chemotherapy, it's going to be suffering, but the plan now is to just document everything and put it out there to show, to hopefully like lift off the fear a bit more. Yeah, because the fear is real. So we are actually just filming everything, and hopefully we can do like a weekly update on that part. In terms of real life, there are just people coming up to me and say thank you for the inspiration. Since then, every time I make a video, I just try to see if there's a message to put out, you know. Even the crazy ones, even the full retard videos, like, I'm sure there's a way to, you know, push out a message. Because people watch this and I realize that I know most of them just watch it to turn off their brain at night because they're tired. But if they could take away something more than that, and maybe it could brighten up the day. That's why even on Instagram, I'll just try to post out positive stuff from now and then. Because I get messages saying thank you, saying it helped make my day start better and stuff. So it kind of shows people need even just a text of encouragement, you know. Yeah.